Blackstone Publishing presents Walt Whitman Speaks, his final thoughts on life, writing, spirituality, and the promise of America, as told to Horace Traubel, edited and with an introduction by Brenda Wineapple. This book is read by Henry Strozier. Introduction by Brenda Wineapple. In 1855, no one had yet heard anything like the raw, declamatory, and jubilant voice of the self-proclaimed American, one of the roughs, a cosmos, that is, Walt Whitman, who famously announced, "I celebrate myself, and what I assume, you shall assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you." In his dazzling poetic debut, Leaves of Grass, published near the 4th of July, Whitman was unequivocally declaring his own independence from poetic conventions and niceties. He didn't even include his name on the title page, although on the frontispiece there was a portrait of a bearded man, without cravat, his shirt open, with one hand on his hip, the other in his pocket, and his hat rakishly tipped back. Here was a poet of the people for the people, without pretension or pomp, who wrote in a verse form that captured everyday speech, both its fluency and its clank. The best writing, Whitman would say, has no lace on its sleeves. And now, in this volume, Whitman again speaks to us, this time from his home at 328 Mickle Street in Camden, New Jersey. "I seem to be developing into a garrulous old man, a talker, a teller of stories," as he told his friend Horace Traubel, the blue-eyed 29-year-old who was transcribing in shorthand most of what Whitman said to him during the last years of Whitman's life. By the time Whitman died in 1892, Traubel had accumulated about 5,000 pages of these conversations, a monumental chronicle of Whitman's reflections, ruminations, analyses, and affirmations. In many ways, Whitman and Traubel had been collaborating on a project begun in 1888. Although Whitman didn't know exactly what Traubel was jotting down, he understood that Traubel would write of their relationship one day, telling the trusted younger man, "I want you to speak for me when I am dead." As Whitman further explained, "You will be called on many a time in the future to bear witness, to quote these days, our work together, the talks, anxieties, the victories, defeats. Whatever we do, we must let our history tell the truth. Whatever becomes of us, tell the truth. For he didn't want to be mummified. Do not prettify me. Include all the hells and dams," Whitman instructed. And when Traubel read back to Whitman some of what he'd transcribed, as he sometimes did, Whitman replied with satisfaction, "You do the thing just as I should wish it to be done." He had found his very own Boswell. Whitman had first encountered Horace Traubel about 15 years earlier, shortly after the poet had arrived in Camden in 1873. Traubel was carrying a large stack of library books, and Whitman had joked about a boy reading too much. They quickly formed a friendship. And together they sat on the front stoop to discuss what they'd been reading, or they'd watch baseball games together on the Camden Common. Initially, a number of people complained to Traubel's mother that her son shouldn't associate with such an old lecher. But Traubel, who greatly admired the poet and his work, volunteered to run errands for an increasingly infirm Whitman. Whitman had moved into his brother's home in Camden after suffering a stroke, and though he regained some strength and mobility, he continued staying with his brother's family, where his mother was also then living. After her death, when the rest of the Whitmans left Camden, the poet purchased a small two-story row house on Mickle Street. By 1888, Traubel was stopping by every day, usually on his way home from nearby Philadelphia, where he worked as a bank clerk. As Whitman's unofficial amanuensis, He answered Whitman's letters, scoured Philadelphia for the kind of pens that Whitman liked, and was soon marshalling Whitman's friends together to help pay for his caregivers and nurses. Traubel arranged benefit lectures to defray their expense, and he organized the birthday dinners and iced champagne that delighted Whitman.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.